Okay, so sorry everyone, there was some interruption because of network issue. So I think I stuck at reporting page. Okay, so as I was explaining, when we are conducting any research or any study, so that should be reported to journal or to public platform, because sometimes I have seen or we have seen that when result is negative of any study, will not publish it, okay, or will not report to any journals. So that's wrong. When we are conducting any study, that study can benefit to the public, can benefit to the academic purpose, for clinical purpose, so that should be reported. Okay, the next one is confidentiality. So it's a author's responsibility or researcher's responsibility who is conducting the research. They should make confidential of individuals' data who are participating in the study, okay, that their images cannot be used directly without proper consent of the participants. Their personal identity we should not disclose. So we should maintain the confidentiality during any research processes. The next one is copyright and permission. Okay, so copyright means when we are using someone's data, when we are referencing someone's data, so prior permission, or if we have to see that some copyright issues are there or not. So that also we should consider, that copyright and permission of previous data or previous literature we are using in our study. Next one is data access and retention. When we are conducting any research, when we are conducting any study, so after publication of that study, all the data related to that research or study should be maintained or should be stored for 10 years at least. So any public authority, any journals, if they want or they want to access the data, so they can easily access with you people. Either it should be saved in your institute or organization, or it should be stored with you only. Okay. So next one is, according to Institutional Ethical Committee of Human Research, there are some principles of ethics, okay, like autonomy, beneficence, non-beneficence, and justice. So when we are conducting any research, when we are doing any research, so we should respect the persons or individuals or who are participating in our study or any human, their autonomy we should respect. Okay, if they don't want to be a participant of our study, so we'll not include in that study or research process. Okay, so their autonomy or their rights we should respect. Next one, we should not harm the human being for our study purpose only, or we should take care that when we are doing any experiments, when we are applying any modalities for research purpose, so the benefit should be there to the patient or that individual who are participating in our study. Okay, so according to some guidelines are there for ethical guidelines, the publication of any research or any research study, like ICMR, I turn the camera, I'll show you people this one. Okay, so here we can find the ethical guidelines for review and publication, ICMR, ICMG, COPE, and CONSORT. Okay, and these are my references. So hope you learned by this lecture that everybody wants to get publication, everybody wants publication of their study, but during the process, when we start from that planning of research and will report to any journals, newspapers, anything, when we want publication in public data form, so there are some steps where mistakes can be there, and that all mistakes I have explained to you people. So please, it's my request, or I can say a take home message, that when we are conducting a research in our physiotherapy field, so please consider the quality of the paper, not the quantity. Okay, because one paper can impact your professional image and as you are related to your professional environment, so whole professional environment can have a wrong impression. Yeah, so thank you everyone, and we can discuss here in the comment session when I'll finish my lecture. Thank you for watching me.